Welcome back to the monthly community update. This month includes chart updates, several delighters to enhance the developer experience, and more microflow capabilities in the web modeler.
Last month, we added single sign-on to SAP Cloud through our web browser. In this release, we added the option to log into the desktop modeler using your SAP account, making it easier to deploy apps directly to SAP Cloud. On the user experience front, it's now easier to view custom theme and externally linked theme files by using the view mode. This lets you see how they look without having to leave the desktop modeler. With your help and ideas to improve Mendix, we have released new delighters to improve your productivity. Creating branch lines has been streamlined to remove performance bottlenecks. We have simplified the dialog and made mainline the default option. Finding usages works great, but wouldn't it be cool if you could follow where a usage is ultimately referred from? Well, now you can, because finding usages has recursive abilities starting with this release.
Charts are getting a welcome announcement with support for dynamic sets of series. Instead of configuring static series, they can be based on dynamic data. For example, it allows you to show the orders for a customer, where each customer is a chart or a bar. Action buttons receive an update this month, including a new delete action, as well as a create action. This means the create action can now be used directly from the navigation. We also updated the open page action to use specialization, so you don't have to use a microflow to open the page you want. Plus, all action buttons are disabled on click by default to prevent errors from users overexcitedly double-clicking.
Thanks for the ID, Nico Kruisinger.
The web modeler continues to add new functionality, enabling citizen developers to actively contribute to the application development lifecycle. This month, we've added a bunch of new microflow activities, expanding the possibilities for adding logic in the web modeler. It's now possible to create and change variables, which is helpful when using conditionals to set attribute values. It's now also possible to aggregate lists to some values and use that data in charts.
To celebrate the start of the summer with the community, we hosted a special meetup where, instead of knowledge, we shared a barbecue-style buffet. More than 60 developers shared stories, ribs, and a couple of drinks. If you're interested in sharing knowledge, connecting with other developers, and expanding your Mendix network, keep an eye on the community website for upcoming events. That's it for your July community update. Check out the blog for the latest Mendix news, and don't forget to like and subscribe to get notified on the latest videos. Thank you for watching, and see you at the next release.